Hello simulation friends and welcome to another Ortho for XP 130 tutorial, where today I want to show you how to create multiple tiles at a time, so in one big tile building process, and this has been one of the more frequently asked questions in my complete Ortho for XP 130 tutorial for beginners and advanced users. And since this is a follow-up tutorial, and I'm not going to explain every single step in greatest detail this time, you should definitely watch the complete Ortho for XP tutorial first, if you are new to the program. And you will find a link to that tutorial in the video description. And now let's check out how to create multiple tiles at a time. And there are several ways of doing it, dependent on the amount of time you want to invest, and thus the amount of extra features per tile. So we will have a look at how to do it a very quick and dirty way, just building several tiles without any further tweaking. Then we are going to have a look on how to define custom zoom levels per tile, with higher zoom level areas within them. And finally I will show you the most complex way of doing it, by adding Alpilot Access HD Mesh into the mix. So let's get started. So let's start by taking a look at the settings. And everything right here is default, except the two values that I changed to improve the water appearance with Ortho for XP tiles. And that's the use masks for inland set to true and the ratio water set to 1. And you also will need to specify the custom overlay source folder, so you will get autogen on the photo scenery tiles. I have mine pointed at the HD mesh scenery folder from Alpilot X. And if you don't own the HD mesh, then you have to enter the default Explain 11 Global Scenery folder. And after you have everything set up on this page right here, don't forget to click Write App CFG, so this path right here will be remembered for all tiles, and apply, and then you can exit. So for today's demonstration purposes, we will create some photo scenery tiles in the UK. So let's start with the most easy way to create multiple tiles at a time. You will just hold Shift right here in the map view and click the tiles you want to create. So they will be marked in red, and then right here on the left in the Batch Build Tiles section, you will check Assemble Vector Data, the Mesh, the Water Masks, the Imagery and the Extract Overlays function. So the first four items right here resemble exactly the ones at the top, if you want to create single photoreal tiles, and then the Extract Overlays function is separate, and this will be also needed for the creation of autogen on the photoreal scenery. And when these are all checked, you can just click Batch Build, and the program will build all these selected tiles with photoreal scenery with the imagery and the zoom level that you have selected right here in the main window. So in this case it would be Bing at zoom level 16. And as I said, this is the quickest way to do it, but you won't have any custom zoom level areas within the tiles. But there's also a way to do this, and we will have a look at it right now. So now comes the little more complicated part, to set up custom zoom level areas within the tiles you want to create before then doing the batch build. And to do this, we just start by double clicking the tile in the map view so that it gets active. In the main window, we make sure that the imagery provider and zoom level are correctly set. And then we go to the custom zoom level function. And right here we can further tweak the tile. So dealing with clouds in the imagery, or selecting higher zoom level areas for airports, for example. This right here is Manchester Airport. So we will cover that in higher zoom level Google imagery. And I will fast forward time right quick. And that's it, we have covered Manchester Airport and the surrounding areas in higher zoom level photoreal scenery. So by clicking apply right here, the program will remember all the custom zoom level areas and also apply those when doing the batch build. So after we click apply, we can exit this window. And this process can be done for every tile you are planning to create. So now we will select the tile to the right of it, double click this area, and again going to the custom zoom level window, selecting our preview, and the same steps can be applied for the next tile right here. Right here we have Leeds Bradford Airport, and I'm going to cover that in higher zoom level area. So a quick fast forward again, and that's the higher zoom level areas done. And again we click apply and exit. So the custom zoom level areas for these two tiles have been set up, and now we can select these tiles by holding shift in the map view. And again, we are going to select all the necessary steps right here for batch building. And now for demonstration purposes, I'm actually going to build these two tiles in batch build. And as you can see, it reads dealing with tile 1 of 2, and it starts with tile 53-3, which is the one on the left. And when it's done with this tile, then the next one will be processed, which is 53-2. So when finished, these tiles will be completely built with overlays. And now also the second tile is completed. And as you can see, the batch build process for these two tiles, with base zoom level 16 and some higher zoom level areas included, took 31 minutes for me. So just as a quick reference. And right here in the tile output folder, you can see the both newly created tiles. And right here also the overlays have been created. So that all went fine. And now finally, let's check out how to add AirPilot Access HD Mesh to the batch build process. Oscar Pilot, the author of the program, states that the integration of HD Mesh doesn't have any positive effect, whereas some other people stated that it's absolutely worth the effort and that it drastically improves the appearance of elevation. So you have to decide if you want to do it or not. I personally would maybe recommend it in areas with great elevation changes, so with high mountains, like here in the Alps. We are going to do some sample tiles in the Alps, whereas for very flat areas there might not be such a great benefit of adding the HD mesh. But without further ado, let's check out how to set it up. I'm going to take three sample tiles right here. It will be 46, 10, 11 and 12. So just as I showed you in my complete step-by-step tutorial, I'm going to copy the relevant DSF files from the HD Mesh Scenery folder in X-Plane 11 into the XP Tools folder, then adding the extension .7z to these three files, then extracting them in place, starting the X-Grinder tool, and pulling these files into it. So you can't only pull one DSF file into it for processing, but also several files. And now the process is complete. And we have got three new files per DSF file that we have processed, and a log.txt file. And since we only need the elevation.raw files, we can safely delete everything else that has been created. And now what's left are three elevation raw files for the three tiles we are going to create. And now let's get back into Ortho4XP. And right here we are going to select the first tile. Make sure it's selected properly. It's 4610. Then we are going to the settings. And right here we are going to select our .elevation.raw file for 4610 right here. So we search for it. And there it is in the XP Tools folder. So now this elevation file from the HD Mesh Scenery is loaded right here. And now we have to say write tile CFG. And that will tell the program that we want to use this elevation file for this tile, and it will remember it also when building several tiles. And we could also do some custom zoom levels for this tile just like before, but I'm going to skip that part right now. And after that we are going to select the next tile, 4611, then again going into the settings and now selecting the 4611 elevation raw file. So that gets filled out right here. Again say write tile CFG. And again we could also define some higher zoom level areas for this tile. And when that's done we go to the last tile for this intended batch build process, 4612, and again in the settings and selecting the 4612 elevation file and write tile CFG, And also for the last tile we could do some higher zoom level areas, just like I showed you before. And when that's all finished, we can go back to our map view and we can again hold shift and select these three tiles that we want to build. And just like before, checking all these boxes right here. And now also the last one, which will tell the program to read the specific tile CFG files that have been created, containing the fitting elevation files from the HD mesh scenery. So we click that as well. And when you now do the batch build, it will also take into account the HD mesh elevation files that we created before. So that's how to include the HD mesh elevation into the batch build process. And just to make a little clearer how the write tile CFG process works in the settings, Auto4XP will create new folders in the tile output folder. So right here you can see 4610 to 12. These have been newly created. And inside them you find a CFG file. And when you open that up with a text editor, you can see right here, besides the default image provider and zoom level, also our custom elevation file that we have set up. So for this tile it's 4610 elevation raw. For the 4611 tile it's also correctly saved. And also right here for the 4612. So that worked. And in the batch build process, Auto4XP will read this CFG file right here and apply the correct elevation to the new photoreal scenery tile. And after you have successfully built all your batch build tiles, then it's absolutely safe to delete these files from the XPTools folder, because it has all been written in the tile output folder of Auto4XP. So you can just delete them and all will be fine. So I hope you found this follow-up Auto4XP 130 tutorial somewhat useful, and I could show you comprehensible how to build several tiles at a time via the batch build process and all the possibilities you have with creating higher zoom level areas within the tiles and also using Alpilot Access HD Mesh. So if you liked the vid, then as usual I would be very happy about some thumbs up and some nice comments. And if you have any further questions, don't hesitate to ask in the comment section, and we'll see if I find more material for further Auto4XP tutorials. So have a good one, and until next time, see ya!